Today, we'll look at how you can use the most advanced, customizable, and realistic sounding AI voice generator called Murf Speech Gen 2.
Here's an example of what an AI generated voice sounds like.
Now, believe it or not, that voice that you just heard was generated all by AI. But what's even more amazing is that I can control exactly how the voice sounds by saying it my way. Here's an example when the AI says some text.
The Kevin Cookie Company bakes the best cookies in the entire world.
Now, that's okay, and it sounds fine, but I would probably say it just a little bit differently. Here's how I would say it. The Kevin Cookie Company bakes the best cookies in the entire world. Now let's have the AI mimic me.
The Kevin Cookie Company bakes the best cookies in the entire world.
That is so impressive. It said it just like me. Along with having it say it my way, I can also generate multiple variations of a line.
Tired of boring biscuits. Tired of boring biscuits?
I can also fine-tune the speaking style from several different options. I can apply emphasis to certain words. With all these features, you can get your AI voiceovers to sound exactly how you want them to sound. And not just part of the way there, but all the way there. And best of all, you could test all of this out for free. I partnered with Murf.ai to show you how this works, so let's dive in. To get started with Murf Speech Gen 2, head to the following website. You could click on the card in the top right-hand corner, and I've also included a link down below in the description of this video. Once you land on this website, click on Open Studio and then create a free account. Once you finish signing up for a free account, you'll land here in a new project and you have everything that you need to pull together professional and very realistic sounding voiceovers. With a free account, you get 10 minutes of voiceover creation, which is quite a bit of time to test out how this works. To get some text in over on the left-hand side, you can upload a script, or over here, you could simply type text in, or you can paste text in. I'll paste some text in. This opens up a dialog where you can specify how you want to paste your text in, and you have a few different options. Up on top, you can split your script by paragraphs, and even within that, we have another option whether you want to split sentences or not. Now, this is especially good if, say, you have one speaker who's going to be reading lots of text. Here you see some scenarios where this might make sense. Down below, you can also split your script by sentences, and on the right, we see a visual of what that looks like. Now, this is really a good option if, let's say, you have a dialogue with multiple speakers. You can choose the speaker for each individual sentence. Or down at the bottom, maybe you don't want it to split up your text at all, in which case you can select Don't Split. Now, for mine, I'm just going to have one speaker, so I'll simply split it by paragraphs, and down below, I'll click on Paste Script. Now that I've imported my text, I need to choose an AI character to read my text. Up in the top left-hand corner of this block, let's click on this icon. This now opens up all of the different available speakers, and there are so many different options. In fact, there are over 120 different voices in over 20 different languages. Over on the left-hand side, I can filter down all of these different speakers. Here, for example, I could choose based on the language. Here, I have English, but I have lots of other options as well. Over here, you could also choose the gender, the age of your speaker, and over here, you could choose the voice style. Now, on the right-hand side, we see all the different speakers, and again, there are so many different options. You'll notice that some of them have this Gen 2 that appears under them. These are the most advanced and most realistic sounding voices, so for this project, I'm going to use one of those. Now, I'm pulling together a cookie commercial for the Kevin Cookie Company, so let's preview a few of these different voices to see who might work well. Let's start with Natalie.
Introducing Perfect Meal, a special formula for your feline.
I like that. That sounds good. Let's listen to you, Terrell.
It only takes one voice at the right pitch.
Not bad. And what about Clint?
Go fast. Go far.
Ooh, that voice sounds intense. And what about Phoebe?
From sharing life's joys to weathering its storms.
Wow, not a bad option. And maybe let's listen to Ken.
Too often, advertisements and commercials interrupt consumers' entertainment.
I think that voice would work really well for a cookie commercial. And over here, I'll click on this heart icon so it's easy to find again in the future. Here, it pins it right to the top of the screen. And right here, I'll click on select. Now that we've selected a voice, we can preview what it sounds like when that voice narrates our text. Over on the right-hand side, let's click this icon to generate audio. Now that it's finished generating, let's listen.
Hey, cookie lovers. Tired of boring biscuits? Our cookies are so good, they will make your grandma rethink her recipes.
Not bad. Now, I think that voiceover is really good, but the nice thing is it's very easy to swap out to other speakers. Again, if you want to try a different speaker, you could simply click on this icon, and here we have all those options again. Now, on second thought, I think actually a female voice would work better for a cookie commercial, and I kind of liked Natalie's voice. So let me click on select, and that now sets her as the speaker. Let's now listen to what she sounds like. Over on the right-hand side, let's generate the audio. And let's now click on play.
Hey, cookie lovers. Tired of boring biscuits? Our cookies are so good. They'll make your grandma rethink her recipes.
Ooh, I like that. I think that works really well. As I listen to the script, I think it would actually serve as a better hook to start with a question than to say, hey, cookie lovers. Now, the nice thing is this editor makes it really easy to get your text in the right order. So here, I want to start with the question. So I'll click on this handle and I can simply drag it up and drop. And now the voiceover will start with this and then go on to, hey, cookie lovers. This is coming together nicely. Up on top, I also have a variety of different controls that I can use to get this voiceover to sound exactly how I want it to sound. Now, right up on top, I can select the speaking style. Currently, it's set to promo, which probably isn't bad for a commercial like this, but I also have all these other options. For example, I could use newscast formal, or maybe sad, or angry, conversational. So lots of different options. And just to show you the contrast, let me select furious, and let's listen to what it sounds like, just so you can see how the voice style affects the reading.
Our cookies are so good. They'll make your grandma rethink her recipes.
Oh, hold on there, Natalie. No reason to get upset. This is a cookie commercial. Right over here, I actually think promo would work better, so let's select that. But I just wanted to give you an example of how you could choose different speaking styles and how they affect the way she speaks. To the right, we also have some additional settings. You can adjust the pitch. You could have it go higher, or you could have it go lower. Over here, you could adjust the speed, quicker or slower. You could also add pauses into your talk track. Over here, you could also adjust how specific words are pronounced. And over here, one of my favorites, you can adjust the variability to fine-tune how expressive it sounds. And you could even adjust the variability for each individual sentence. Now let's listen to this first sentence again.
Tired of boring biscuits?
Now let's see if maybe she could say it differently. Over here, let's click on change variability. Now over here, I could simply adjust how variable it is, or down at the very bottom, I could also generate multiple options. Let's try that. Down below, let's click on get started. Over here, I could select how variable I want it to be. I'll select 3 and then click on generate. Right down below, I now have 3 different variations that we can listen to. Let's have a quick listen.
Tired of boring biscuits. Tired of boring biscuits. Tired of boring biscuits.
Ooh, okay. A few different options, and she says it a little bit differently in each one. I think I like the first one. I'll select that and let's click on apply. Right up on top, it's now used that variant in the talk track.
Tired of boring biscuits?
Perfect. Let's now go down to the third sentence and have a quick listen to this.
Our cookies are so good. They'll make your grandma rethink her recipes.
Yeah, I think she needs to emphasize the word good more because these cookies are so good. Everyone wants to eat them. So right up on top, let's click on emphasis. And right here, we see the sentence or that third sentence in the script. And again, I want her to emphasize the word good. So over here, I'll click on good. And over on the right-hand side, I can adjust the emphasis on that word. So again, let's listen to it as it is right now.
Our cookies are so good. They'll make your grandma...
Okay, right up on top, we can adjust the speed of that word, and we could also adjust the pitch. So let's try maybe slowing the word down just a little bit, and let's also try increasing the pitch. And down below, let's generate a preview, and then we can play it. And now let's listen.
Our cookies are so good, they'll make your grandma rethink her recipes.
Okay, it's subtle, but it really helps drive home how good they are. I like that. Let's click on apply voiceover. Let's now listen to the very last sentence. I'll click on generate and then play.
But be careful, our cookies might lead to spontaneous happiness and uncontrollable cravings.
It doesn't quite match what I had in mind. Now, one of the really neat things is I can also say it my way. I could basically read it, and then the AI voice will mimic the way that I read it. So let's click on this. This now opens up a dialogue where I can record myself saying it. Over on the left-hand side, here I see all of the text, and I also see a record button. Let's click on this icon, and I'll try reading it. But be careful. Our cookies might lead to spontaneous happiness and uncontrollable cravings. Okay, let's see how that turns out. And right up on top, we can now listen.
But be careful. Our cookies might lead to spontaneous happiness and uncontrollable cravings.
Oh, that is so much better. Down below, let's use this voiceover. Once you finish your voiceover, you'll probably want to use it alongside something else. For example, you'll probably want to play some video, or maybe you want some background music. And you can do all of that here directly in the studio. Over on the left-hand side, let's click on the button that says Add Media. Right up here, you can upload your own media, so you could bring in your own audio or music or video files. Right up on top, you can also pull in stock music, and here you'll get a license to any one of these songs included in this interface. Right up on top, you can also bring in stock images or even stock videos. And one of the really neat things, when you bring in stock video or your own video, down at the very bottom, you have this timeline. And here, if I expand this, you could put your video alongside the voiceover, and you could also add music to go alongside your voiceover. Now, this is a very basic video editor. It gets the job done, but chances are you'll probably want to export it to an external program. So right on top, let me minimize the timeline. And in the top right-hand corner, I'm now ready to export this voiceover. So right here, let's click on this big blue button that says export. This opens up the export dialog, and you could decide what you want to export. I simply want to export the voice, so I'll select this. And down below, you have a variety of different options that you can configure. For now, I'll stick with the defaults. And over here, let's now download the talk track. Right up on top, I'll click on download. And here, I now have an MP3 file on my computer with the audio. Let's have a listen.
Biscuits, a cookie lovers. Our cookies are so good. They'll make your grandma rethink her recipes. Visit one of our many retail locations worldwide or find us online at kevincookiecompany.com. But be careful. Our cookies might lead to spontaneous happiness and uncontrollable cravings.
And there you have it. You now have professional voice talent right at your fingertips. Let me know what you think of the Murf Speech Gen 2 voices in the comments down below. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.